To Buddha School, Red Manohara Vasudhara Homa Fire Offering Ceremony has now begun. We would like to welcome our lineage guru, the founder of To Buddha School, His Holiness Living Buddha Lien Sheng, to enter into the Homa Hall. Let us now join our palms with reverence and recite the Rudguru Mantra.
Thank you.
Inviting His Holiness to take the Homa throne. We are also inviting Simu to please take the Dharma throne, to take the Dharma seat. We are inviting Rinpoche and all the Dharma masters to please take the Dharma seats. We are inviting all participants to please take the seats. To bless the prayers of the primary supplicants. The offering of Hatha. Let us now join our palms with reverence. And we would like to invite Vajra Master Chilienyi to represent all of us to present the offering of Hatha to the lineage Sut Guru as the symbol of the highest honor. Namo Manohara Homa Fire Offering Ceremony has now begun. We slice through Buddha lineage. Namo Vayukana Buddha, Namo Buddha Lokana, Namo Amitabha Buddha, Namo Padma Kumara, Namo Living Buddha Liansheng. Visualize Grand Master and all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas sitting on top of our heads, radiating lights to bless us. Recite Padma Kumara Mantra. Perform the visualization of the four immeasurables, relatives and ancestors from the father's side on your right, from the mother's side on your left, friends and teachers behind you, enemies and karmic creditors in front of you, and all sentient beings around you together practicing tantric dharma and ultimately attaining Buddhahood. Wake up call. Recite purification mantras and the earth deity mantra.
Namo Samanto Motoran Om Duru Duru Devei Soha.
It's an invocation mantra.
Om Soha. Om A Hom Soha. Om A Hom Soha.
We sincerely invoke our lineage root guru, His Holiness Living Buddha Liansheng, Namo White Maha Padma Kumara, Namo Lotus Light Self Mastery Buddha, Namo True Buddha School Lineage Gurus. We sincerely invoke the main deity of Homa, Namo Red Manohara. We sincerely invoke the main deity of Homa, Namo Manohara. We sincerely invoke the main deity of Homa, Namo Manohara. Namo Golden Mother of the Primordial Jade Pond. Namo Five Dhyani Buddhas. Namo True Buddha School Lineage, Eight Primary Deities. Namo Yamantaka. Namo Akalanata. Namo Four Heavenly Kings. Namo Sima Bodhisattva. Limbu temples, all Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis, and Divinities. All the deities enshrined at the True Buddha Tantric Quarter, at the Seattle Lejang Temple, and at the South Mountain Retreat. Limbu temples, mountain god, earth god, plant god, wind god, water god, heavenly fire god, dragon gods, and all divinities, as well as the city god, to please radiate light and bless his Homa. Great homage using visualization first to Root Guru and all Buddhas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, release Samudra. Second to all Bodhisattvas. Visualize for prostration on the ground, release Samudra. Third to all Herukas and Dharma protectors. Visualize for prostration on the ground, release Samudra. Fourth head bow. Great mandala offering, form the offering mudra. Visualize the transformations of the offerings to become innumerable to fill the whole cosmic space. Make the offering above to the lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, the main deity of Homa, Namo Manohara, all Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Herukas, Dhammapalas, Dakinis, and divinities, and below to all sentient beings. Man, may rule for continents and sun and moon, transform into precious offerings for the Buddhas. May these tremendous treasures and merits, purse of karma, to allow for self-realization.
Om Sarva Tathagata Itamu Kurunana Menchana Khan Niye Tahyami.
Do For refuge, visualize our lineage root guru, all the lineage gurus, Buddha jewel, Dharma jewel, and Sangha jewel to form bright white light to empower us. We said the mantra.
Namo Guru Pei, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye. Namo Guru Pei, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye. Namo Guru Pei, Namo Buddha Ye, Namo Dhamma Ye, Namo Sangha Ye.
做比较护身, Karma protection, form Vajra Clubs Mudra, reset Vajra Pani Mantra 7 times.
Om Bori Nan Zari, 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 Om Bori Nan Zari.
With reference, we are inviting His Holiness to perform blessings with mala. Inviting His Holiness, Living Buddha Lien Sheng, to set ceremonial demarcation to bless the registration forms, Homa cards, and all the offerings. Please stand up and join our palms with reverence. And together we are inviting His Holiness to perform the ritual of opening the Homa fire pit, to set seven dhammakishas around it, to lit the Homa fire, to make all the offerings and to perform mudra transformations for purifications, enrichments, magnetization, subjugation and birth or deliverance. We are inviting all participants to please recite that mantra of Red Manohara.
Thank you.
is that God mantra of the principal deities and can put him in the
mind. Om Hahaha Vai Samaye Soha Om Jari Juri Junti Soha Om Zambala Chalang Chalaye Soha Om Ahom Beta Guru Bema Siddhi Hom Se Om Ahom Guru Be Ahu Sasamaha Yen Seng Siddhi Hom Deyata Om Beka Zaya Beka Zaya Maha Beka Zaya Raja Samo Kedehe Soha Namo 36万亿，11万9500 同名同号， 阿弥陀佛。 Namo 36万亿，11万9500 同名同号， 阿弥陀佛。 Namo 36万亿，11万9500 同名同号， 阿弥陀佛。
Recite this application to the Buddha to stay in the Sahara. I pay homage and supplicate His Holiness to virtuous and marvelous Tantrika, all Buddhas of the 10 directions of the Buddha lands as numerous as grains of sand, all Bodhisattvas who are full of compassion toward all beings, Herukas, Dhammapas, Dakinis, protectors of Dharma. The nights are long, the three poisons are proliferating. My body and soul are stricken, tumbling, miserable, perpetual rebirth. With great compassion, His Holiness came to this world to salvage the deluded ones. Three jewels emanate wondrous light to provide refuge for all. All fortunate beings, human and devas, like eyes watch your body for the bestowal of teachings, laws, precepts, empowerments, and attainments. We disciples of Buddha believe that you stay in this world to turn the Dharma wheel to benefit and give happiness to multitudes of sentient beings. At a dedication, may all uphold the Buddha, ascend to the realm of utmost bliss, repaying forfeit generosities from above, aiding those in the three realms below. Upon seeing the Buddha, may we transcend life and death. Like the Buddha, may we liberate all. To Buddha's school disciples, wholeheartedly pray to Red Manohara Vasudhara, the lead world deity of the Western paradise, Sukhavati, to please utilize your incomparably majestic hook to hook away and alleviate all of our lineage root guru's calamities and obstructions. We pray that Manohara hooks all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas to bestow upon our lineage root guru riches and dignity. May His Holiness be endowed with health and high energy, favorable conditions and enrichments, joy and happiness, self-mastery and spontaneity. May His Holiness continually stay in samsara to turn the Dharma wheel and guide sentient beings to arrive at the other shore. Inviting His Holiness to perform the oral merit dedication. Wholeheartedly, we pay homage to the Red Manohara Vasudhara. Wholeheartedly, we pay homage to Manohara. Wholeheartedly, we pay homage to the Red Manohara Vasudhara. We pray to Manohara to please turn your Vajra hook by your Vajra hook, please hook all the Bhartu spirits to be reborn into Sukhavati, Western Paradise, Pure Land. By your Vajra hook, please hook away all of our illnesses. By your Vajra hook, please hook all the proper wealth so that all disciples be endowed with ample resources and proper wealth by your Vajra hook. Please hook so that our wisdom is complete by your Vajra hook. Please hook away all calamities, pandemic, and all of disasters, accidents, and all adverse conditions be hooked away. Please bless us with good health, all wishes fulfilled, calamities transformed into auspiciousness and strong spiritual commitment. We pray to Manohara to please bestow clear radiance upon us, that finally we can attain fruition of our hardship, Pratika Buddhahood, Bodhisattvahood, and Buddhahood. To the red Manohara Vasudhara, the wealth attracting goddess, and gods in heavens, gods on earth, may we be far from all calamities, may all calamities abandon us, that all disasters turn into dust. May all of our prayers be granted. May all enemies and enmities disappear. May the pandemic disappear. May the coronavirus disappear. May all sicknesses and diseases disappear. May all bad luck, accidents, and adversities disappear. Recite 100 syllable mantra 3 times. Sato samaya manupanaya pizza sato tenupadita seto me pawa soto kayu me pawa sopo kayu me pawa anurato me pawa sarwa siti me purayata sarwa karma sota me sitamu siti ren guru hum. Ha 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 Great homage and visualization for Surat Guru and all Buddhas. Visualize for procession on the ground, release the mudra. Second to all Bodhisattvas. Visualize for procession on the ground, release the mudra. Third to all Herukas and Dharma protectors. Visualize for procession on the ground, release the mudra. Fourth head bow.
Om Brim, Om Brim, Om Brim, Om Mani Padme Hum. 让我们以热烈的掌声感谢法王圣尊莲生活佛，祝坛勾财天地护摩法会，请大家恭敬合掌，恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛做宝贵的法语。Now
let us join our palms with utmost reverence, and together we are inviting His Holiness for precious Dharma teachings.
传承祖师,
let's pay homage to the lineage gurus.
了明和尚,
homage to the venerable monk Liao Ming.
三家正空上师,
homage to Master Sakya Zhengkong.
十六世大宝法王,
homage to His Holiness the 16th Kamapa. And homage to Master Dubden Dorji. Homage to the three jewels of the altar. Homage to the main deity of Homa today. Manohara, Red Manohara, Vasudhara. Simu. Tanzen Katso. Tutan Siddhi. All Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma lecturers, Dharma assistants, directors of temples and chapters, and all disciples present here and over the internet. Good afternoon, how do you do? Good afternoon, everyone. How do you do? Aishiteru. Sarangi.
Hola, amigo.
Hola, amigo.
Te quiero mucho.
Te quiero mucho. Skoyin. Ichiban. Kimochi. Jumi.
Yabi. Bling bling. Konnichiwa.
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 Now I would like to announce for next Sunday, December 6th. Wow. The year is almost ending. December already. At Sunday 3 p.m.
白杜姆的护魔法会,
there would be White Tara Homa Fire Offering Ceremony.
那么, 白杜姆,
White Tara is also referred as the seven-eyed Buddha Mother, because she has eye in each of her palms, on her face three eyes, and at the sole of her feet two more eyes. So she is the seven-eyed Buddha Mother. Together with Green Tara, one is White Tara, the other Green Tara. They are both belongs to the family of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, Guan Yin. According to the Tibetans, when Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva was compassionate towards sentient beings, shed tears, and one drop of tear became green Tara, another drop of tear became white Tara. Her mantra, Om Beja Guru Ya Soha. And her mudra is the same as Green Tara's. The same as Green Tara's mudra. And White Tara, of course, is white. Her body is all white. And she looks very dignified. One hand is forming the wish-granting mudra, and the other mudra is the lotus-holding mudra. So lotus-holding mudra and wish-granting mudra. And many people have White Tara, the seven-eyed Buddha Mother, as their yidam. So, practicing the Tara practices, green or white Tara, can achieve spiritual union easily. The Karmapa once said that in the daytime he practiced the Tara Dharma practice, and at night he practiced the protectors, Mahakala. So this white Tara is extremely dignified. So, if you want to become primary supplicant or you don't want to become primary supplicant, go ahead. And today we practice the Red Manohara Vasudhara, and Manohara had manifested many miracles. The Dharma sister Ying from Thailand also had miracles and more. Among us here, there's one who's chanting Manohara's mantra for 7 days, and immediately she felt the response. And Manohara, of course, what the response would be, because she's related to wealth. I cannot say who that is. That by chanting Manohara's mantra for 7 days, she received a spiritual response. I cannot tell who that is, though, because if I do, it'll be difficult to say. Just now we talk about White Tara, and White Tara had a response. It was White Tara who went to Master Dukden Dorji to have him go to Taiwan to find someone with Luo family name, and he would help you spread your Dukden lineage. I have said it before, that was White Tara who told him. So it's very accurate. She knows about a lot of the future. And he was looking for the Luo family name with a different Chinese character, and he did not realize that Luo, like Grandmaster's name in Taiwanese, is Luo Senggan. And then he said that he couldn't find anyone with the Luo family name. So White Tara told him again that that person with the Luo family name has come to your temple. So prior to the Dharma teaching, I want to start with a joke. Someone had a pet pig, and after raising him for a long time, started to get tired of him, so wanted to abandon him in the wilderness. But the pig was very smart and could remember the way back. Doesn't matter where he was being thrown out, he came back every time. And one day, the master took the pig to a very, very remote mountain wilderness. After turns upon turns upon turns, and then it's getting dark. So the master called home and asked his wife, "Is the pig back home again?" And the wife said, "Oh yeah, he's back long ago." So the master got really angry, "Have the pig get the phone, I am lost." That's very funny. That's a joke. When we were young, we were little, we often say the word limpe. It's like your old dad. Like you refer to yourself. It's like your old dad. One time when I was in Taiwan, I saw the name of a shop, and it's called the Your Dad's Cafe. And my car's license plate, we didn't do it intentionally. And the license plate for the white Rolls Royce.
Like a B-U-C. B-U-C.
B-U-C.
Buddha Kami.
They say, B-U-C, they say Buddha Kami.
C, just Kami. Just for life.
So the Buddha is coming.
Buddha coming.
That's easy to remember. Buddha coming. And then the number 6428. The numbers.
6428. 6428.
So 6428, and then they said, they didn't say that. I am your dad. They say, is that?
乐死临别，重戏。
Make your dad happy to death.
我们每次讲说乐死了。Because
we always say happy to death.
二八嘛。Happy
to death, your dad.
这也是一个很巧合的事情。That's
also. What a coincidence. My Maserati
AVT. AVT.
It's
AVT.
The first three letters are AVT, Avantar.
Avantar.
Like Avatar, Avatar, Avatar.
A 就是 R, V 就是凡，哦，然后 T 嘛，哦，阿凡达，阿凡达，阿凡达，阿凡达，阿凡达是什么？就半神人。
So that's half human, half God, Avatar. And the numbers, I forgot.
9951. 99
means like for a long, long time. It's always number one.
就是我很久很久。五就是我第一名。Five
means I. So for a long, long time, I am number one.
人家叫我说。So
two cars. So my numbers are very easy to remember. For a long time, I'm number one, and the other one. Make your dad happy to death. So people from Southeast Asia, they would buy the four number lottery immediately.
我记得还有一个笑话。
I remember there's another joke. One time I was in Singapore. They are the human carried peddler, you know. So that was fun. So we rode on that human carried cart. And seeing I was a monk, he turned around and asked me, "Hey, master, give me four letters. Give me four letters." And I said, "Sure, Caesar." And I said, "Caesar, Caesar." Loving kindness, compassion, joy, and equanimity. He almost cursed. But actually, four characters meaning four numbers. Oh, talking about Singapore. Question and answers. 莲花何时正 from Singapore.
莲花何时正，请师尊谈一谈开言三大事。
Could you please talk about the three pioneering patriarchs to Chinese Tantric Buddhism? Subhakarasimha, Amoghavajra, and Vajrabodhi.Their attainments, treatises, and parts that we can learn from. He's testing me. This is like a test question. So the three pioneering patriarchs, Subhakarasimha, Amoghavajra, and Vajrabodhi.Their attainments, treatises, and parts that we can learn from. Subhakarasimha, Amoghavajra. Who is the guru of Amoghavajra, Vajrabodhi? Jinkangzi.
我印象中那个不空也是上无畏的地。那么慧果老和尚，这个长安青龙寺
，the venerable elder 慧果 ，from the 青龙 temple in 长安 ，is a disciple of who？
是不空的地。
Disciple of Amoghavajra。
这已经有人讲不空是上无畏的弟子，那么慧果老和尚是不空的弟子，这个错了，不关我的事，是他们两个讲的。
I don't know if this is wrong. They said it, not me.
我印象中也是，我的印象中也是。
In my impression too.
还真的是没有答案。
There are no answers. Subhakarasimha went to the Tang Dynasty and went into the palace. Subhakarasimha and Vajrabodhi.Amoghavajra. They are the. So when the Tang Dynasty started, these three monks went from India to the Tang Dynasty and they.Propagated Tantric Buddhism. Of course, they are truly great. Subhakarasimha, Amoga Vajra, Hui Guo, and Kukai. Kukai went to the Venerable Elder Hui Guo at the Green Dragon Temple and obtained all the tantric dharma of Chinese Tantrayana, and Kukai went back to Japan, which is the Japanese Tantrayana or Singon, was by Kukai through receiving empowerments and lineage from the Venerable Elder Hui Guo, and got a lot of the tantric dharma practice procedures, and he went to Chang'an and returned to Japan and got to Changmen at the Kyushu, landed there, and he established Japanese Tantrayana. So Japanese Tantrayana the lineage came from the Venerable Elder Hui Guo, who was brought to Japan, the same with Vajrabodhi. There are treatises and areas we can learn from. Let me tell you that lineage is extremely important. We have to learn Subhakara Simha transmitted to Amoghavajra, and Amoghavajra transmitted to the Venerable Elder Hui Guo, who transmitted to Kukai or Kobudaishi from Japan. And the result that all Japanese Tantrayana was established by Kukai and Zuichen, who learned the Tantai Tantrayana. That's why it's called the Thai Tantrayana. And Kukai's is considered Chinese Tantrayana that became Japanese Tantrayana once he brought it back to Japan. Therefore, lineage is very important. Grandmaster holds the lineage from Master Dubden Darji. I always remember the lineage. The great living Buddha from Mongolia, Kanzu, living Buddha, during the Qing Dynasty, he and the Zhangjia living Buddha, these two Mongolian living Buddhas, were during the Qing Dynasty. And the living Buddha Kanzu transmitted the Dharma to during the Qing Dynasty, the one who compiled all of tantric dharma during Qing Dynasty. Do you remember who that was? Whom did he transmit the dharma to?
Dubden
Nima. Right, Master Dubden Nima. And Dubden Nima, during the Qing Dynasty, Tantrayana flourished in the imperial, the royal palaces of Qing Dynasty. And Master Dubden Nima transmitted to Master Dubden Dali. And Master Dubden Dali transmitted to Master Dubden Darji. That's your guru's guru. And Master Dubden Dorji transmitted to me Dubden Chimo. Dubden Chimo. So this lineage you have to remember. This is the lineage. That's the lineage belonging to Master Dubden Dorji. So all the lineage gurus. The eight great patriarchs. The first one is Nagarjuna. The first patriarch of Tantrayana in India was Nagarjuna. Second, Nagabodhi. Nagabodhi Bodhisattva. The third patriarch is Vajrabodhi. And the fourth patriarch is the Amoghavaja. Yes. So Vajrabodhi was the guru of Amoghavaja. Vajrabodhi was the guru of Amoghavaja. When Amoghavaja entered into Luoyang, translated Vajrasekha Sukara, Vajrayoga, practice Vairocana Samadhi, was translated by Vajrabodhi. The merits of Vajrabodhi. And then the fourth patriarch is Amoghavaja. So Amogha. And the fifth patriarch is Subhakarasamma. The sixth is Yixing. The seventh patriarch is Hui Guo. And the eighth is Kukai. So first Nagarjuna, second Nagabodhi, third is Vajrabodhi, fourth is Amoghavaja, fifth is Subhakarasimha, sixth is Yixing, Zen Master, seven is Hui Guo, eighth patriarch is Kukai. Where did we print this out? So fast, immediately. Master Lian Chuan printed it out. So I don't need to say anything. You can just check this. That's why, let me repeat, that lineage is extremely crucial. See, Master Dubden Dorji. Master Dubden Dali. Ganchu, Living Buddha, Dubden Nima, Dubden Dali, Dubden Dorji, Dubden Chimo. That's the lineage. So, we have this lineage. In the past, I remember this lineage is very clearly. I cannot say that because I'm old now.
Over.
that sometimes I would forget. We all know. When you reach 70s, you would forget. In the past, I would remember right away without asking.
Tan
Tzu Erwa. Kupilahan. The fifth Kan Tzu Erwa was Hutu Ketu, transmitted to Dubden Nima. And then Dubden Dali, I say Dali, it said Dali here. And Master Dubden Dorji. And Living Buddha Liansung is Dubden Jimo. And the Sakya Sek, the great perfect supreme wisdom Dharma. That's the same. It's all the same. So what you give me is all the same. So I remember the lineage very clearly. I have said that once in a while I would forget something. I'm in my 70s. In the 70s, you start to forget things, right? At 1, you're born with merriment. At 10, you're into your studies. At 20s, you're at the top of your youth. In the 30s, you're into career. At 40s, you start to gain weight. At 50s, you're at the top of your middle age. At the 60s, your blood pressure start to rise. At 70s, you start to forget. At 80s, you wobble when you walk. At 90s, you completely forget everything. At 100, you hang on the wall. So now I sometimes forget. So that's accurate. So what we should learn is you have to remember your lineage. Your true authentic guru has a true authentic lineage. Without the true lineage, then the guru would be fake. And Grandmaster has another very special lineage, the topmost secret lineage, which is lineage attained through samadhi, empowered by the lineage gurus, by the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. That kind of lineage is most secret. So we have to highly revere the lineage and the attainments. We have said that earlier. Vajrabodhi, he translated many of the tantric dharma practice procedures. And we also know that eventually they transmitted to Hui Guo, the venerable elder Hui Guo, who transmitted to Kukai, which was the 8th patriarch. And the whole of Japan had the lineage of Kobudaisi or Kukai. So lineage is extremely important. You need to remember your lineage. Subhakara Sima, I remember, he entered into the palace, also Vajrabodhi.
他们在皇宫唐朝的时候弘扬这个中国的密宗，叫做宗。
That during Tang Dynasty, they spread the Vajrayana Buddhism to China. That's why it's called the Chinese Tantrayana. And there was the Tian Tai Vajrayana. That's called the Tai Tantrayana. And the Chinese Tantrayana then spread to Japan, which became Japanese Tantrayana. So, Tian Tai Vajrayana, not Taiwanese Vajrayana. Tian Tai Vajrayana that belongs to Mount Tian Tai. Translation is of utmost importance. And the part that we need to learn is to learn to translate Grandmaster's books into many different kinds of languages to spread them all over the world. And from Taiwan, Lianhua Juncheng. During my practice, while chanting Root Guru Mantra until in concentration, all of a sudden, from inside, I emit white light, and the light fills my whole body. And the only thing left on my mind is knowing that I'm chanting. My question is the Dharma flow of the universe, not only outside but inside as well. Should a practitioner practice until the inner and outer Dharma flow merge together? Just like what Grandmaster once said about the child light merging with the mother light, asked by Lianhua Juncheng from Taiwan. What you asked was correct. That inside our body, we originally already have light. And there's light outside, there's light inside. And the child light, which is your own light, merge into the mother light to return to the ocean. It's like a drop of water entering into the great ocean. All of a sudden, from inside, I emit white light. That's right. When you're in concentration, chanting Root Guru Mantra, the light fills my whole body. The only thought I had was knowing that I was chanting. That is correct. Light sometimes is not from outside, but from inside, inside your body. So, the Karmapa, the 16 Karmapa in Chicago, he was hospitalized. He passed away in a hospital in Chicago. At the moment of his death, he taught his disciples around him that at the moment of death, maintain the light inside your heart. Maintain the light of your heart. That's your own light. You have to make it appear. And by this light, you merge into the light of the universe. So the child light merging with the mother light, that's also not wrong. So the Dharma flow of the universe, of course, is not only outside but inside as well. Because Sakyamuni Buddha once said that all sentient beings have Buddha nature. And how do you symbolize this Buddha nature? You can symbolize it with Dharma flow, with a clear light radiance, or with the highest wisdom of emptiness. Or it can be symbolized by the empty nature. Or that you have realized the wisdom of emptiness. So to which level, how many percent of wisdom of emptiness and how many percent of wisdom? In the beginning, the emptiness is 30%, existentialism is 70%, and they gradually rebalance. That you reach the wisdom of emptiness, and that would be empty nature, the same as Buddha nature. And it's also called the clear light radiance. Of course, the child light and mother light merge together and reflect upon each other. That's what it meant. As by Lianhua Jinchen, that was right. That the Dharma flow of the universe not only outside but it's also inside. And then the inner and outer Dharma flow merging, that's right. And then your light merge with the light of the universe and you have attainments. And asked by a Thubuddha disciple from California, United States, did not say the name. Beloved Grandmaster, when my eyes jump outside my control, I feel as if the Buddha is talking to me. Are eyes jumping by themselves related to spiritual union? I really want to know if there's a special meaning to the eyes jumping. Someone said something like jumping in the left eye is auspicious, jumping in the right eye is disastrous, or vice versa? Anybody knows? So left eye is bad, right eye is good. This is right hand. This is right eye. When this eye jumps, that's good. And the left eye is bad. Bad sign. You're not talking about the eyelid, you're talking about the muscle. You're talking about the eyes. This person was talking about the eyes or eyelids. You're talking about the muscles. When you have twitches in your muscle, that's signs of strokes. We said this before. When the left eye is jumping, you cut a piece of white paper and place it there until it stops. Why do we use the white paper? That means you're jumping for nothing, which means all the bad things would disappear. So auspicious here and bad here, I think that's what they say.
心会不自主的跳动，好像我
说
话。请问眼睛跳动跟
The eyes jump outside my control.
眼皮跳动吗？
Are you talking about the eyes or eyelids? This person wrote the eyes. My eyes never jump. I'm just talking about the eyelids.
我告诉你，他的跳动可是真的气到那里。他的感应是在
That jumping is probably because the chi went there.
收眼皮。
If doing a Dharma practice.And the eyes are jumping. That's that person's special response. Some people, the jumps are in the fingers, like Grandmaster's divination. As soon as you concentrate and calm down, the fingers would be like.The needle of an instrument, it would open and close.
更厉害的话就会开始这样子动。
And even more, it would start moving like this.
像仪器一样这样。
It would just like an instrument, and you ask questions, and it would tell you. It would tell.This is divination using fingers.
那这是师尊的手掌啊，自动抖动。
This is Grandmaster's palm.
跟活菩萨联系的一个方法。
That moves by themselves. This is a way of communication with the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
可能跟他的本尊或者跟他的灵。
So his or her eyes are moving.Perhaps it's a communication with the spirit. So the eyes jumping related to spiritual union? Yeah. So when the eyes are jumping, so you are communicating with his or her spirit or the Buddha. Is there a special meaning to the eyes jumping?If you're already talking to the Buddha, why don't you ask the Buddha?
会的，我告诉你，真的是会的。
Really?
为什么我讲会呢？有人依照这个。
Really, it works.
也很有感应。
Someone encountered something like this and very accurate.
他是问的，我现在要做一个事业。
That person asks, I want to do this business, and should I do it? And he or she asks the yidam, and then makes your eye jumps. If it continues to jump, then that means I can do it. And then if I should not do this business, then the jumping would stop.Then, is it right if I do this? It would continue to jump. That means yes. If I should not do this work, then the eyelid does not move at all. So there's a response.To the questions. Should I befriend this person? And if it jumps, that means yes. Should I befriend this person? Move and then stop. That means no. Do I have affinity with that person? It keeps jumping, yes. Do I have affinity with that person?Jump a little and stops. That means no. Very simple. So that's also the worldly dharma, mundane dharma. The same with this palm. Concentrate, empty everything, And then the fingers would start to open. Am I giving Dharma teaching now? Yes. That's how it is. Very easy. So when my eyes jump outside my control, I feel as if the Buddha is talking to me. Are eyes jumping by themselves related to spiritual union? Yes. I really want to know if there's a special meaning to the eyes jumping. Means you can communicate to him directly. But first, you have to empty yourself. You should not have any ego, because if you have your own intention, then then you will make mistakes easily, then there would be misunderstandings. If you are completely empty, then the answers would be accurate. If you don't try to manipulate or to fabricate anything, then without manipulation or fabrication, it would be accurate. That's Grandmaster's experience. So I have formed many mudras. Or playing with the Vajra Bell and Vajra Scepter, that was taught by Vajra Sattva. So Vajra Sattva taught me how to play the Vajra Bell and Scepter. And when I formed this mudra, what happened then? I joined my palms and they moved by themselves. And they form many mudras by themselves. They all move by themselves. When I was 26 as a survey officer in the surveyor team, they always came every night for 1 hour. So they taught me all those mudras. I just sat and joined my palms, and the fingers would move by themselves and form the mudras. That's how I trained. Everything was taught by them, and also the feet, the hand gestures, the feet gestures, they were all taught by the intangibles. And what I said was all truthful, but if I lied, and I fabricated that, then everybody can leave me. You can ignore me because I lied. So really, they were all taught by the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. And the one that leaves the greatest impression, I have said this before, they lifted my leg for a long time and I started to feel sore. I wanted to put it down, but I could not move. I was standing on 1 foot for a long time. And if they didn't let me let my leg down, I could not let it down. My body was frozen. Then I discovered that the intangibles do exist. So when they lifted my leg, even when I wanted to put it down, I could not.
So I 刚刚讲的就是我写的刚刚看起灵血啊。
What I learned about the movement of the qi, about the spiritual divination, etc. Those were all the initial spiritual responses that I received in the beginning. I wrote them all in my earlier books. And the one who followed me,at the very beginning was Zheng Yixun.
Lai
Xici.
Lai Xici.
So Mu Xian's dad.
We
knew each other long ago. Before I knew you, I already knew your dad. Zheng Yixun, who brought the three brothers, Lian Huo, Lian Si, Lian Zhu, to visit me at my Li Xing community's house. In the early times, there were a few senior disciples. They all passed away. Xi Sui Wang. They all passed away already. Such is life. I was at the survey team, and they taught me little by little, and I visited so many ordained monks and Taoist masters. Nobody knew what's going on with me then. And I had the vision of Padma Kumara too.And they did not know about Padma Kumara. This was all in the past.
Wow,
5:04 already? Let's talk about Lamdre. Part 2. Briefings on the extensive exposition. On the summary revelation of the cause to rise to meditation. So what is the cause to generate meditation? In some, in the verse, in quotes, Luo Qia, etc., Luo Sa, etc., end quote, refers to when the mind qi accumulates at the secret Luo Qia area of the navel, one will see yaksas in the sightings and in the dreams. So it talks about meditation. When you accumulate, gather the mind qi at the navel chakra and visualize these two characters, Luo Qia, then one will see yaksas. Yaksa belongs to the realm of ghost. The first etc. in the verse, refers to when the mind qi evenly accumulates at the former right, ya qia and ya ma areas as the cause. So,
ya
ya and ma areas as the cause. The result would be the spiritual experience of the mind, which utilizes the latter, in quotes, etc., which includes yaksas, yamas, flesh eaters, and more, which give rise to the arrogance of the father continuance. So it still talks about which chakra, which character, and when in meditation you enter into those areas, what you will see. So arrogance, yama kings, the medicine generals, the yaksas, flesh eaters, Buddhas, those are all ghosts, a kind of asuras. So the four heavenly kings have lots of yaksas and those monsters or demons following the four heavenly kings. So the father continuance, which means the male types. If the mind qi is evenly accumulating at the left ma, ma, di, and za, etc. characters, it will generate all sorts of mamo, mamos, poisonous snakes, wild beasts, ugly evils, Buddhas, bihus, etc. One will understand more during the path of abandoning sufferings and faults. So, demons in the form of animals or beasts, and their ghosts who look like gods, or ghosts who look like animals. So, the improper gods, so this is like thunder. The thunder strikes on the improper gods, improper or not righteous. So gods who are very close to the ghostly realms. So you step your left foot, and this is the thunder mudra, and you blow breath, and then you throw it out by stomping your left feet. If there's a ghost inside somebody's body, the ghost will run away. So this is the thunder mudra, and you blow breath on it, and the ghosts will abandon that person's body. So this all talks about the ghost. Yaksa, yama, flesh eaters, Buddha, they're all the godly ghosts. Mamos, poisonous snakes, wild beasts, ugly evils, demons, Buddhas, bihus, they are all godly ghosts that are very ugly or look like beasts, wild beasts. So you visualize ma, di, za characters, or in meditation you visualize acha, ama. Then these things will appear for you to see during meditation. when you're focusing at the navel chakra, this will happen. Today we visited a customer and I got lost in the alleys and I asked a little girl for direction and she said, just continue straight and continue straight and straight and straight and straight and then you'll get there. And then I asked, why did you say so many straight and straight and straight? And she said, oh, because it's very far. It's like the answer given by Zen master. And you ask, what is Tao or the path? Just walk straight. That's the path. If you walk straight, that's the path. In the past, when the alarm sounds, I would push the snooze button and continue to sleep. But ever since my mom placed three mouse traps on the clock, I changed my bed habit. Because when you try to push the snooze button, you would be caught. When shopping, and if I see that the shopkeeper is a beautiful girl, then I would buy something that would cost 520. And then the lady would say 520. And this is in Chinese, 520. 520 in Taiwanese, it sounds like I love you. And then I would reply, yes, I love you too. So this is a new way to pick up a girl.
520 just 我爱你, 我爱你.
A little kid kept following a pregnant lady for a long time and crying. And after a while, the lady got impatient and asked that little kid, why you keep following me? And the little kid replied, I lost my balloon. Did you hide it inside your tummy? That's kids' talks. Oh, money pay me home.
非常感谢根本上师法王圣尊莲生活佛宝贵的法。
We are truly grateful to His Holiness Precious Dharma teaching. This ends the English interpretation today. Thank you very much.
观想顶礼，回天心善印；二拜诸菩萨，嗡啊吽观想顶礼，回天心善印；三拜诸护法金刚，嗡啊吽观想顶礼，回天心善印；四平等以其寿。
恭请师尊师母移驾到荧幕前，在众线上通往弟子们。
好，
师母好。
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 师母
好。
师母好。
师母好。师母好。
师母好。
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 师母
好。
师母好。
师母
好。
师母好。
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 师母
好。
师母好。
师母祝你哋身体健康，
身体健康，
家
事顺利，
家事顺利，
爱你哦，
我爱你，
我
真
心的哟，
爱你，
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 我要来每个人做
饭，
天主啊，
来做，
来做，
不好，
我提醒
我
好，
我爱你，
师尊，
我不想来吗？
现在二点多，
我爱你，
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 我爱你，师尊，
我爱你，
很爱很爱你哟，
来，
爱你哟，
父母的谢谢。
不离不离，
晚上
不离不离，
我经常看，
好，谢谢谢
谢
谢谢，
好，
谢
谢
谢谢，
爱你，
感恩
主家，
祝我好，
祝我家
祝我
好，
祝我家
祝我好，
请世尊法王圣尊莲生活佛赐受勾财天女法灌顶。